Dear colleagues, today I'm going to present my paper, which title is Overview of European Educational Projects on eLearning and Related Methodologies, Data from Erasmus Plus Project Results Platform. This research work is being carried out within the University of Salamanca Programme on Education in the Knowledge Society, with the mentoring and supervision of Francisco José García Peñalvo. The research is motivated by the increase in the use of information and communication technologies in modern society and the need of improving the teaching and learning process in that field. We have decided to use the Erasmus Plus Project Results Platform, which contains all the projects funded by the Erasmus Plus program, because it allows us the selection of those that are labeled as good practices or success stories. This database constitutes a good starting point to gather the preliminary necessary information in order to identify key factors that make those projects valuable, aiming at developing a guide that would allow teachers and teachers trainers to know the key factors that help to achieve a good design of educational projects and provide an optimal use of ICT resources and the greatest impact on the teaching-learning process. At this stage of the research, the screening and sample selection of projects is being carried out. In order to make the screening process, these mapping questions have been raised, taking into account the type of study and the set of meta-questions proposed by the Guidelines for Systematic Research Projects Reviews, a method described by Alicia García Holgado, Samuel Marcos Pablos, and Francisco José García Peñalvo. We are going to analyze the results obtained. The first mapping question is related to the distribution of projects by their connection with e-learning and other related methodologies, and as it can be seen on the graphic, the amount of projects related to e-learning is much bigger than in the case of mobile learning, blended learning, ubiquitous learning, and other methodologies. The second mapping question has to do with the countries with coordinators or partners involved in Erasmus Plus projects connected to e-learning, and we have found that Italy is the one with the most number of projects, followed by Spain. The third question has to do with the distribution of e-learning related projects by action. The findings in this case are that Key Action 1 and Key Action 2 are the most relevant, and the fields more active in projects connected with e-learning are the school education, followed by vocational education and training. The fourth mapping question is related with the projects classified as good practice or success story. Around this question, several factors have been analyzed. One of them is the number of good practices or success stories by country, and Spain is the country with most coordinators and partners involved in good practice or success story projects. The second factor analyzed is related to the most addressed topics, and the first one has to do with innovation in the curricula, and the second one with ICT and digital competencies, both of them very relevant for this study. There are three more factors analyzed. One of them has to do with different types of coordinators, as it can be seen on the graphic, educational centers are the most relevant. Another one is associated with the distribution of good practice or success story projects by CallGR, and the last one is related to the barrage funds per action. In conclusion, after viewing the projects linked with e-learning on the Erasmus Plus Results platform, the following criteria will be taken into consideration for the screening and sample. Those linked with the term e-learning from Key Action 1 and Key Action 2 with more than 50 e-learning projects, so as to consider them representative, involving educational centers and labeled as good practice or success story. Thank you very much for your attention. Here you have my contact details in case you wish to get in touch with me.